we are back with an interview that is going to rock. We are here with two members of the Orange Belt Mineralogical Society. Welcome back to the show. I know you were here not too long ago.
Yeah, thank you for having us back.
Jess Pearson and Tim Summers.
But you brought somebody new.
I did this time. Yeah, Tim Summers is new. Mm-hmm. Not new to the club, but new to the show.
Yeah, so definitely.
Glad to have you come along.
For those that didn't do the first segment, give us a brief description of what you guys do.
We're Mineralogical Society. We're a nonprofit. We work on educating the public, teaching them about rocks, some geology, as well as what you can do with them. We do a lot with, as you can see, quite a variety, silversmithing, casting, wire wrapping, painting.
You have like a variety of kind of everything, and you brought a new variety, which just shows how much you guys really have.
And I kind of brought a work in progress, so these kind of are how they start out naturally, and then we work down to this and into the actual cabochons, which we've been turning into some of the jewelry. Mm-hmm. So.
And you guys have been around since 1933.
Yeah, that's
right. Which
is
a long time, not as long as all these rocks, but it's still a really long time, right?
We're one of the 5 founding members of our Federation for California, yes. And actually, that's a neat thing too, coming up, our Federation show. So that'll be in May, and we're going to look forward to volunteering down there for them.
Very cool. What's the Federation?
All of the rock clubs in California together.
Wow. So, nice. Kind of a big family reunion almost.
Exactly.
Right. So. Bring all your art together. And they all do art also.
Yeah, you'll see a ton of it. It's going to be at the Pomona Fair now. So. Mm-hmm. Looking forward to participating in that, as well as our own show coming up.
So. Now, since you were here a while ago, I'd love to hear, like, what's it been like since the first time you were on the show?
Oh, it's been fabulous. We've grown a lot. We've got a lot of new members come in. Mm-hmm. This is one of our new members. She's taken to painting and carving. Penny carves these pieces. And we have some more that are into the chainmail and everything. We've
chain
grown a lot.
Like this
is chainmail here. This is dragon skin.
Yeah.
So you guys are also, these artisans are getting involved with Renaissance fairs too. You're mentioning so many events.
Yeah, we really are. Several of our members are doing crossover. So they'll come and they'll make the stuff there and then they get involved in the other things. So one of our best silversmiths is doing crossover right now with a Ren fair as well.
Such amazing work. Now, I'd love to hear how Tim's involved. You brought Tim with us.
I did. Tim is our show assistant show coordinator, but he actually has a really neat way of rock hounding, and I'm going to let him tell you about it.
Tell us.
I do quite a bit of diving, and I travel.
So diving.
I dive and I snorkel.
So like diving in the water.
Yes, scuba diving.
Right.
And we go chase the stones underneath the water.
You chase them. Are they running away
from
you?
They're not going fast. That's why I like that. They don't move fast and I don't have to either then.
So what is that experience like?
It's, well, if you've ever dove, it's just looking for stones underneath, and it's an enjoyable, quiet afternoon to do.
It does seem very relaxing, actually.
And do you find different rocks underwater as opposed to them being on land?
You probably have a greater variety. There are not so many people that have been digging through them when you're underneath the water. They've had a chance to be underwater and tumble just a little bit. So
nice.
You can pick up quite a bit.
What are some of your spots that you go diving at?
I do a lot at Catalina, and I have picked up some rose quartz and that out there and some other stones. So up and down the coast.
What are the most prized stones or the rocks that you folks, when you find them, you're just like, yeah, this is a gold mine right here?
There is quite a selection. I'm still learning quite a bit more. We were on a dig up in Mule Canyon, behind Mule Canyon, and got some agatized palm that has cut very, very nicely, gem quality, and very beautiful. So we have a whole lot to offer for a whole family experience of literally going out and field tripping, where you're digging the rocks out of the ground to cutting them and making them into jewelry. So it's
beautiful
everything
jewelry.
In between.
Yeah, and what a great adventure. It sounds like an adventure to me.
It is.
A little something for everybody.
Mm-hmm. And then you get to bring something home and keep as a souvenir, as a remembrance. And one something that I asked you earlier, I was like, so do you add any color to these rocks or they dyed? And you said they're just as beautiful as God made them, right?
That's the way God made them. We just get to polish them a little bit.
There you go,
They really are stunning. You mentioned souvenirs, and Jess brought one of your artisans. Her name is Nancy, right?
Nancy,
let's give her a shout out.
Nancy is a very gifted. Her stone of preference happens to be the black jade.
Yeah, it's so beautiful.
Well,
fabulous. Thank you, Nancy. It matches my outfit, too.
No, it looks great.
Now, you guys mentioned field tripping. I hear there's a trip coming up to Big Sur.
We are. We're planning a Big Sur summer trip, as well as we're going to go looking for some Tourmaline here pretty soon down in San Diego at the Tourmaline Mine as well. Mm-hmm. So, and this is some from our last trip. This is black tourmaline. So we're going after green this time. So looking forward to that as well.
It almost sounds seasonal a little bit. You know, different times that are good for you to go out. Would that be accurate?
Only to the point that you don't want to be, like, say, in the Mojave Desert in the middle of summer.
Right.
So we look at moving our coastal trips to the summertime, and then our winter trips can be more desert-related.
Yeah, definitely.
So
absolutely.
That's kind of a better idea.
So what would you tell somebody that's interested in possibly trying to learn this craft?
Oh, give us a call. Check out our website, our Facebook. Mm-hmm. Come down. We're more than happy to show anybody whatever they like.
Even if they have no experience.
No experience. And you can start off from as simple as talking to people about the rocks, finding out what they are, and a lot of the old timers will show you how to cut them and actually help you learn the different techniques from taking them from a raw stone like this to a polished like this, and setting into a setting. Mm-hmm. There's always somebody there that was more than willing to help.
More than willing to help.
Oh, yeah. And that's amazing. Offer classes all the time. Mm-hmm. And our show is coming up in the last weekend of June, and it'll be next to City Hall in Rialto. We're looking forward to that. We're going to have several different vendors there. Perfect. And just a lot of artistry.
Where can we go to get that information for that show?
You can go to OBMS Rocks on YOLA.com. Come down and see us. We're at 205 West Benedict on Arrowhead Avenue, right down the street.
It's Arrowhead for some reason. I like that.
There you go.
Either or works. Yeah. We're happy to greet you either way.
Come on down. We'll show you. Hope you show you what you do on the things. Have fun and look at stuff.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Tim.
Thank you so much.
And Jess, thank you
for having us back.
Yes, and please come back again. Definitely check their website out, everyone, and we will be right back.